Far in the west of Wales are the Black Mountains. And there among the Black Mountains, in the region called Myddvai, there is a lake. The lake is deep and dark, so enclosed by mountains that it is only on midsummer that the sunlight rests upon the surface of those dark waters. And it was one midsummer, long ago, that a shepherd, a young shepherd, went to graze his flock of sheep by those dark waters. And as he rested there, with his sheep eating the rich green pasture, the sunlight fell upon the dark waters. And from the water there stepped three sisters, three lake maidens. And as they stepped out of the lake, shining drops of water flew from their hair. They walked among the sheep. One of them came close to the young shepherd. And as he sat there looking, he reached with his hand the crust of bread that he had brought with him. And she laughed. "Hard baked is your bread. You cannot have me." And she laughed and returned to the waters, and with her sisters she stepped under the waters and was gone. The rest of the day and that night, the young shepherd could not sleep, could not do anything without remembering that beautiful sister. The next morning he rose early. He made dough, put it in the oven for just minutes so it was still soft. And he went with that soft baked bread. In the same place he rested, and once more, when the sun rested on the surface of the lake, the three maidens stepped out laughing, the droplets shining in their hair as they fell from their shoulders. And the same sister passed close to the shepherd, and he held up the soft-baked bread. But she shook her head. "Soft-baked is your bread? You cannot have me." And laughing, she returned under the waters, and his heart was full of despair. How could he not have this lake maiden whom he loved? The next day, troubled, he came back to the lake with nothing. But there, as he arrived, he saw floating on the water bread, neither soft nor hard. And he picked up that bread and waited, and sure enough, when the sun's rays fell upon the surface of the dark waters, the three sisters once more emerged. And the same sister passing close, he offered her the bread and she took it. "Now you will come with me. You will be my wife." "I will not come with you unless tomorrow you can tell me apart from my two sisters." And laughing, she returned under the waters. But how could he tell her apart? For they were alike in every way. The next day he returned to that place, and the three sisters came out once more from under the waters. And he pointed. You are the one I love. For I can tell by the way that you have buckled your sandal." Well, he was right. "I will come with you, but not for long. I will marry you, but our marriage cannot last. This is my home under these dark waters. You will strike me three times without good cause. When you have done this, I will leave you forever." "I will never strike you," said the young shepherd. "How could I strike the one I love? Come, come." And she left behind her sisters, and as she walked away from the waters, she called for her cattle. Brindle cow, white speckled, spotted cow, bald freckled, old white oxen grey, white bull, black calf, come follow me. And from under the lake came these magnificent cattle, oxen, cows, bull and calf, and they followed her down from the lake to the shepherd's home. And they prospered. They lived well. Not only sheep, but the most wonderful cattle. Soon they had horses. All was well. The shepherd no longer poor. Together with his wife had three sons. Their lives were full of joy, and yet there was always a sadness about the lake maiden, as if this was not quite her home. One day they were invited to a naming ceremony. A child had been born in the community. When they left the house, a wind was blowing, a chill wind. I am cold, said the lake maiden. Fetch my gloves. I will fetch your gloves, said the former shepherd, now farmer, if you will go and fetch the horses. He went into the house and brought the gloves for her, but she had not moved. She gazed towards the mountains. And angry with the gloves, he struck her on the shoulder. Husband, you hit me with no good cause. Once you have struck me, twice more, and I will be gone. He regretted what he had done. More time passed, and the farmer and his wife were invited to a wedding. When they arrived, the guests were full of joy. There was dancing and laughing. But the lake maiden, the lake wife, she fell on the floor and wept tears of sorrow. Her husband was angry. Why do you cry at a wedding? And he struck her on the shoulder. She rose to her feet and glared at him. Husband, you strike me again for no good cause. Why would I not cry at a wedding? For those who enter into marriage enter into trouble. More time passed. The farmer was at great pains to avoid becoming angry with his wife again. But there was a funeral to be celebrated. They came to the funeral and the people were weeping and mourning, crying, wailing. But the lake wife, she danced and sang and laughed. And her husband, embarrassed, angry, struck her. 3 times you have struck me, husband. Why do you dance at a funeral? Why do you laugh and sing? I laugh and sing. For those who leave this life behind, leave their sorrows behind. And now I leave you behind, my husband. And she walked away from the wedding and up towards the mountains, and he could not prevent her. And as she walked towards the dark waters of the lake, she called for her cattle. Brindle cow, white speckled, spotted cow, bald freckled, old white oxen grey, white bull, black calf, come follow me home. And the cattle, they followed her. The pair of oxen that had been ploughing a field, they left the field and followed her up the mountain, and behind them they left a furrow which scarred the mountainside and can still be seen to this day. The cows too followed. The white bull burst free from its enclosure and came running after. And the black calf that had just been slaughtered took itself down from the butcher's hook. and the blood no longer dripped as it followed her, and all of the cattle went under the waters of the lake. He never saw his wife again, but his three sons did. Sometime later, when they were older, they went to the lakeside. There they stood. And out of the lake came their mother, the lake wife, the lake mother. And she gave to them the power of healing, recipes, prescriptions that they wrote down and took away with them. And those three boys became great physicians, great doctors. They were known as the physicians of the mother. And after that, they passed on their knowledge and skills to their children, and their children's children. To this day, the ancestors of that lake wife have the power of healing. And those first three, all of those medicines that they wrote down, that book that they wrote it in, exists. It's in London. You can go there and read it. Learn about the old ways of medicine that were learned from the woman of the lake. I myself went to Myddvai with my wife about 5 years ago. We climbed up to the shore. Indeed, the waters were still and black. And I tell you, if you go there, you will believe this story as I have told it to you. If you could give something to that shepherd, if you could give him one thing, what would you give him? Just don't tell me, tell the person next to you. If you could give him one thing, what would you give him?
Happiness.
Happiness?
Yeah.
Can you explain?
I don't know. Wi-Fi.
You would give him happiness?
Yeah.
You want him to be happy. Full of sadness for his mistakes. Full of regrets.
Yeah.
Thank you very much. Oh, I feel so much happier now. Yeah. Thank you. Happiness. I like it. What would you give for the shepherd?
Handcuffs.
Handcuffs?
Just so he wouldn't slap the wife.
To stop him from slapping the wife. Yeah.
I mean, he could do it anyway, because he could just sit like that.
But it might stop him.
Maybe.
Behind the back.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, handcuffing behind the back permanently. Difficult to do. No, I understand what you're saying.
Maybe he will head by her.
He couldn't stop himself. He couldn't prevent himself. And she knew that.
Himself.
He couldn't control himself. And she knew that would happen.
You might as well prevent it.
But what would you give him?
And your wife.
A new wife? Does he deserve a new wife?
Yes.
Do you think he will learn from his mistakes?
No.
You are very optimistic. He will learn from his mistakes and he will never do that again. What would you do?
I would kill him.
You would execute him. Because? Because then he's released from this world of troubles. Do you think in the next life he can meet her?
Yeah.
Maybe they can meet in another world, in the life beyond. Yeah. Interesting, when I ask this question, I have no idea what people will say. It's very interesting. Happiness, handcuffs, freedom from this life, and a new wife.